Today, the Lord speaks to us of our identity. What is your identity? Who are you? Every time in the depth of our heart, we do ask this question, who am I? Why am I here on this earth? What am I busy with? From where have I come? Where do I go? These kinds of questions do arise from our hearts. And God says, hello, my dear, who are you? Maybe you can call yourself that I am a priest. That's what the world has given me. Or I can say that I am a son of so and so, my family background. Or I can say my family influence. Oh, my sisters and my dear ones are in Singapore, in London, and this ABCD. Or I can speak about my caste. Or I can speak about my talents. I'm a great composer. I'm a great preacher. Many things I can speak about me, but they are nothing. They are not the permanent ones. The moment I am sick, I can't even stand to preach. That is the end of my preaching ministry. If I move away, my dear ones are passed away. I can't tell them anymore. As long as the parents are there, they care for us. Once they are no more, our brothers, if we are lucky, they care for us to an extent. And if they are also elder to us, they will pass. And their children, if they have, they may care for us to an extent. The relationship is not our identity. It's a gift of God given to us to grow in God. The job we have, the talents we have, is not the same. The other day I was listening to the voice of Sushila. When I was a small boy, she was known as Cuckoo, her voice. Today it is shivering. She is not able even to sing little high pitch. Once upon a time she used to sing. She is getting old, going to the grave. Her voice is gone. Once upon a time, the beauty queen, Jayalalitha, today she can't even wait for 10 minutes. Her body is gone. She can't even stand for 10 minutes. Everything, the so-called great in the world, pass away. That's why in 2 Corinthians 4:18 says, don't identify yourself with that which is passing away. And when that passes away, if you identify, you will feel empty at the end, unbroken. So identify yourself with that which is eternal and permanent, which is true. You and I have come from God, and we are here. Yesterday we belonged to Him, today we belong to Him, tomorrow also we will be belonging to Him. How do we belong to Him? He says in today's first reading, He says, I have married you. I have married you. You are mine. I am your husband. I am not your master. What a beautiful word the Lord says. I am not your master to direct you, to guide you, do this, do that. No. All I have, all that belongs to the husband. The moment a woman marries, the palace belongs to that woman. The orphan girl, Esther, when she married the king of the nation, she was taken to the palace. Everyone bowed before her because her husband was the king. This is what the Lord wants us to know. God says, I am your husband. I have married you. You are mine. If a woman does the things which are not pleasing to the husband will not keep quiet. So, what is my identity? What is my way of life? The moment I am married to somebody, I cannot do whatever I wish to do. My husband tells me, this is our life. This is, you are a queen. You have to live like this. You have to behave like this. The kings will come. You have to dress up like this. You have to address like this. You have to come along with me. I will be meeting certain dignitaries and you have to accompany me. You can't say, I am tired. I am weak. Sorry. I am your husband and I have married you. He says, and in that day, I will make a covenant with you. You will be called, you will call me my husband and no longer my master. I will take away from your mouth the names of Baals, and they shall be remembered by their name no more. Once upon a time, they come from a particular family, particular situation, particular tribe. Now, no more. You have only one name. You have only one address. Only one identity you have. That is, you belong to God. You are here to move with your husband and to live with him, your God. You're married to him. You are responsible to him. He needs you. He wants to train you. You have to praise him. You have to thank him. You have to worship him. You have to vibrate his presence and vibrate his vision of life. You are sold to him. He has bought you with his blood. That's why in verse 21 onwards he says, it shall come to pass in the day that I will answer, says the Lord. I will answer the heaven. You know, when you call upon, you know what will happen? You will be calling upon on this earth. And the earth will be calling upon heaven. And the heaven will call upon the Creator, your husband. He will say to the heaven, go, she is mine. He is mine. I will answer the heaven. The heaven will answer the earth. And the earth will produce all that is needed for you. How he connects everything with you. The greatest sin, as John Paul II, the Pope said, is losing the consciousness of who am I to the Lord. Consciousness of sin. No, this I should not do. This is displeasing to my King, the one who married me. I am no more mine. I cannot do whatever I wish to. This consciousness is lost. That's what Pope John Paul II says.